Just a touch. Thank you for that nice introduction, Wes. I appreciate so much the partnership that you and I have in public safety. We have a very safe county, as you know, but we do face challenges from gangs, especially heroin. And our police officers and sheriff's deputies do an unbelievable job apprehending these criminals and bringing them to justice. But then their job is done. After that, it's up to the office of the state's attorney to prosecute that criminal and to put them in jail. And I have to say there has been a sea change in the state's attorney's office since Wes Adams took charge of that office. The days of the easy plea bargains and slap on the wrist, over. If you deal heroin in this county, or you're a member of a gang, a murderous international criminal gang, you are going to jail. Thank you very much. I've been around this county for 50 years now, and I've had the opportunity to experience Annapolis, the city of Annapolis, from a whole variety of different perspectives. As a Marylander, I know our city to be the capital of the state of Maryland, and of course the home of our incredibly United States Naval Academy. We love our midshipmen. Resident, I know that this is one of the most wonderful places to live on earth. We are so fortunate to live here in this community. And as a business owner, even now in the city of Annapolis, I understand that the actions that government takes can make it easier to do business and create value and jobs, or government can make it a lot harder. And finally, in my current capacity as county executive, which our county obviously surrounds Annapolis. Annapolis is the dead center, the heart of Amarillo County. I see the jurisdiction of the city of Annapolis as key to the overall success of Amarillo County. In fact, I think a successful Amarillo County is indispensable to the long-term future of the city of Annapolis, and vice versa. Both jurisdictions have to be successful for the other to succeed. And for all of those reasons, it is important that Annapolis be led by the right person. And I believe very strongly that that right person is here tonight. I'm going to speak with you in just a minute. He's also a business person. He understands that very same issue I mentioned a moment ago about the role of government in job creation and building an economy, or working against those very same objectives. And talk about walking the ethical line. Mike Pantelides is an Eagle Scout, and in all the time I've been working with him, I've never seen him get off the line. Ethical as the day is long. Political priorities and policy initiatives that they're too numerous to even make a dent in trying to list them. But eliminating a $7 million structural deficit and balancing the budgets, while not only avoiding new taxes, actually cutting property tax rates. When was the last time that happened in the city of Annapolis? The Wall Street bond rating agencies increased the outlook on the city's bonds because of the strong financial management of the city today. That's a far different place than the city was in only a few short years ago. Mike is also doing steps to clean up our waterways, taking steps to clean up our waterways, obviously immensely important to the city of Annapolis, growing jobs by bringing on an entirely new economic development operation in partnership with the county. More and more, you can just go right down the line, taking all the right policy steps. But the thing I value most, what I value most about Mike Pantelides is the spirit of partnership that he has brought to his relationship with Anne Arundel County. For those of you that have been around for a while, you know that the relationship between the city and the county usually runs somewhere between outright hatred and lukewarm at best, right? And that's to the disadvantage of the citizens of both jurisdictions. That ended the day that Mike came into office. He brought in that spirit of partnership that has allowed us to work together on so many different initiatives, all of them making life better here in the city of Annapolis for the citizens of this great city. We are cleaning up new streets. I think we pulled, 15 derelict boats out of there, something like that? I mean, Williams Creek has never looked better than it looks today. Oysters being planted together through a joint venture between the city and the county. I mentioned economic development. We have now a joint office of economic development that's attracting businesses and helping job creators expand their businesses. And you see that in the numbers, 400 new or recently expanded businesses in the city just during the 3 years of Mike's administration. That's incredible. That's incredible. It speaks volumes about his efforts. We're working together in public safety to combat this heroin problem, to combat gangs. I don't believe ever before have the city and county worked so closely together in the area of public safety, and we all know the importance of that. So for all those reasons, I am so excited about being a supporter of Mike Pantelides as he runs for re-election. Now, when Mike won this election almost 4 years ago, it sent a shockwave around the country. Nobody saw it coming. National news was a big deal. And it was a big deal because our friends on the other side of the aisle believed that they were entitled to that mayor's seat for life, for perpetuity. And when Mike won that seat, it was a shock to them that how dare we change their plans for them and put someone like Mike Pantelides in the seat of mayor of the city of Annapolis. And I will tell you that it was such an important political event in this city, county, and state that it unquestionably, in my mind, paved the way for my subsequent election as county executive and Larry Hogan's subsequent election as the governor of the state of Maryland.
So the first thing we did is said we have to do things differently. My election was about change. I didn't get elected because things were going well. I got elected because people wanted to see something different in the city. And that's what we've done over the last 4 years. And I'll just give you a couple of highlights. The city was broke. And not just broke, we don't have money. We were actually in debt. $7.5 million. We had two rounds of massive tax increases. When you knock on people's doors, they can't afford to pay more. We had trash service cut back to once a week. And the city was so broke, it had to borrow $20 million to be payroll. So what do? We said we're going to work in a bipartisan fashion, and we passed four budgets without raising the tax rate in the city of Annapolis. Things outside of the box. It's always raise taxes, cut spending back and forth. Let's try to be innovative. Let's try to do something different. And we did that with the Annapolis Renewable Energy Park. We had a closed landfill in the city, literally just a pile of trash. And we released it out to a private developer. They're going to put 55,000 solar panels. It's going to make the city $4 million over the next 20 years. Green jobs, green energy. It's a win-win for everybody around. So we have to utilize technology. It's one of the keys on how we're going to move this city forward. So we've done that in a number of ways I want to share with you. Many people know Forest Drive is bad, and when you get stuck on an accident, you can sit there for hours on it. So I said, what can we do to make it better? So I had everyone research. That's the one of the things I'm very proud of. I always push people, and I never accept no for an answer or mediocrity. I always say you can do better, you can always work harder. It's kind of my dad's motto to me as I was growing up. So I said, let's look at technology. So we're getting drones in the city of Annapolis. So in the old days, an accident happens. It takes police officers 3 hours to clear the road. Now you can fly up drones, take pictures. It can be done in a third of the time, be done in an hour. I said, we got a parking problem downtown. How are we going to fix that? People are always running out, putting quarters in a machine. I said, we live in the 21st century. Everybody's got a cell phone. You can pay with parking with your cell phone. Well, a lot of people don't want to ride the bus. Why? You don't know when it's coming. So what do? We got an app on a smartphone. You can see in real time, like Uber, where that bus is coming along. We had hundreds of underutilized parking spots. I see Sam in the back over there. So we changed the city laws. We said if you have a business, you can lease out your parking to the public. We've opened up over 100 spaces to make it easier to park downtown. One of the things and the difference between my opponent and myself is you have to have a plan for what you're going to do. A lot of people have good intentions, but it comes down to how are you going to pay for it, how are you going to implement it? You know, people say they don't want to have parking lots on city dock, and I agree. Everybody wants green space. But are we just going to rip it up and shut down all the businesses? I don't think that's the way to go. But what we are going to do is we're going to build the Hillman Garage, hopefully a level higher and a level lower. And if we can do that, we can get rid of all the parking spots down there. Part of having big things is the way we do our police department, the way we change it. You know, public safety is so critically important in this city. And I just want to highlight two things that we've done. Number one, we work to make sure our fire department is a class one fire department. To put that in perspective, out of 157 cities in Maryland, only two have that distinction as a class one fire department. That means everyone in the city is eligible for a reduction in their fire insurance rates. We looked at our police department and said, you know, we have to do more. So we hired 10 new officers in the upcoming budget. But that's not enough. We have to do more to engage with the community and build trust, build relationships. So we switched to a community policing model. People getting outside of their cars, talking with people on a one-on-one basis. We implemented body cameras, another piece of technology, to build trust within that community. We're all about doing things differently. And that's what we're going to keep doing over the next 4 years. When I think about the city's future, there's a couple of areas we've got to focus on. One's the environment. You know, we talked about the energy park, we're retrofitting all the buildings, but how do we deal with stormwater management? We took a leadership role, and we're partnered with Anne Arundel County. We put $1 million to build new projects. There's all this new technology and innovative ideas, and I want to do them here in Annapolis. I don't want to follow somebody else or read about it in the newspaper. I want to be the one people read about in the newspaper going forward. Yes, we didn't raise the tax rate in the city of Annapolis, but how do we bring in more businesses and more jobs? You know, we have a very robust jobs program and opportunity for people. Because I'll tell you, as mayor, the number one thing people ask me for is a job. All the time I walk up to people. Do you have a job? Can the city hire you? And it breaks your heart if you say no. So we've launched a number of job fairs in the city. We did one for the Energy Park, one for Mayor Live, for other private sector people. But probably the one I'm most proud of is our Second Chance Job Fair. You know, there's a lot of people in this country that have committed a crime in the past, and they don't have the opportunity in bars to employment. So we launched a program to work with 10 private sector employees to give people a second chance to employment. We had 130 people come by that program to find work and opportunities. And that's just some of the ways we're leading to work for all of Annapolis going forward. And when we talk about all of Annapolis, we've got to look at our housing authority. You know, anybody that reads a newspaper knows the Annapolis Housing Authority was one of the worst run, most corrupt housing authorities in the country. And everyone told me not to do anything. Mayor, don't do it. It's too political. You won't be able to make a change. You won't make a difference. I said, I don't believe that. I didn't get elected because I'm not going to do something about it. So we put a brand new board of commissioners in place. I'm the first mayor to ever go around and demand inspections for their quality of life. That's the theme of this campaign. When I did this, it was very controversial. They said, the mayor's coming in. He's going to kick everyone out. He's going to gentrify the area, right? So people were scared. I called my office. Please don't kick me out of my house. We didn't kick anyone out. I went door to door and talked with residents. I care about how you live. I care if your shower doesn't work or you have black mold or your dishwasher doesn't work. And we had a warm reception. I got a book this city of things we made at the housing authority fix for everyone in this city. You know, I look back at what we've done and how we're going to build on. You know, a lot of people said, there's things that just will never happen. And I see John Bruno and Mike Keenan back there with the former faucets building. People said, that's vacant for a decade and it'll never get done. I said, not on my watch. We work together with them. It's under construction. And I think it's going to be one of the best things in the city. Now a Mission Barbecue. They looked at an empty pocket park, it's a brand new Starbucks coming. We're finding ways to fill these vacant buildings up in the city of Annapolis. And how do I do it? I do it because I'm very blessed to have family, friends, and supporters like you. I have a great leadership team and department head. I can't do this job alone. And we built that team out. And I think that's one of the messages we have to share with people. It was a big learning curve for me going in. It wasn't easy, made a lot of mistakes along the way, but we've grown so much over the last 4 years. And we've got that momentum going, and we want to carry it out over the next four. And that's the difference going forward. You know, we can't afford to go backwards. We have to keep moving with this positive momentum, keep making changes, bringing people in together. And I want to close by talking about how your support can help. Because it really is you all that make a difference in this election. You know, as I go door to door and talk with people, we have a lot of signs around town, we've raised a lot of money, we've got a lot of people that are supporting us. There's people that are supporting my opponents. But the thing that I was the most shocked about is how many people are undecided. And my campaign manager and team always tell me, these next 30 days are more important than the last 3 years. These 30 days are when people make up their mind. So if I can get you all to help me, whether it's knocking on a door, calling your friend, we've got some Facebook videos to share out, emailing them, sending them a letter, the personal one-on-one contacts from you is what's going to make a difference in the election. So I'm asking everyone for their help. I've been truly blessed to have this job. I believe I'm in it for the right reasons. We've made a lot of success and change going forward. And more importantly, we're going to keep doing it. I promise if I'm elected mayor, I'll never quit, I'll never back down. And I will call you.
Listen to them and talk my God, because this election is the future of our city. and it is important to leave that off for the next 30, 40 years, and how many hours?
Well.
Thank you very much, and appreciate your support. Please have a seat.